Hello everyone, I'm Mahdi Zoravand. Welcome to our educational video on meshing methods in computational mechanics. Today, we'll explore three critical approaches, Eulerian, Lagrangian, and Arbitrary Lagrangian-Eulerian, or ALE meshing. By the end of this presentation, you'll gain a solid understanding of how these methods work, their applications, and their strengths and limitations. In this presentation, we'll cover the following topics. 1. Introduction to the three meshing approaches. 2. Detailed explanation of Eulerian meshing. 3. Detailed explanation of Lagrangian meshing. 4. Detailed explanation of ALE meshing. And 5. Comparison of these methods. Eulerian meshing is a technique where the mesh, or grid, is fixed in space, and the material or fluid flows through this stationary mesh. In this method, control volumes are static, and physical quantities such as velocity, pressure, and density are calculated at fixed spatial points as the material moves. The advantages of Eulerian meshing include, it's particularly well-suited for problems involving large deformations, fluid flows, and fluid dynamics. It handles scenarios where material interfaces and boundaries are not well-defined or change significantly over time, such as fluid flow around solid objects or multiphase flows. However, there are some disadvantages. It's less accurate for problems involving large displacements or deformations of solid materials. It requires complex algorithms to track material interfaces and boundaries effectively. In contrast, Lagrangian meshing involves a mesh that moves with the material. Each node in the mesh is attached to a specific material point, moving as the material deforms. The advantages of Lagrangian meshing include: it is ideal for problems involving solid mechanics and finite deformations, as the mesh naturally conforms to the material. It simplifies the tracking of material interfaces and boundaries since they are inherently followed by the mesh. The disadvantages are, the mesh can become highly distorted in cases of large deformations, leading to numerical inaccuracies and the need for frequent remeshing. It's not well suited for fluid flow problems where large-scale movements are common. ALE meshing is a hybrid approach that combines features of both Eulerian and Lagrangian methods. In ALE, the mesh can move independently of the material, allowing for dynamic adjustment to minimize distortion while still partially following the material. The advantages of ALE meshing include: it combines the strengths of both Eulerian and Lagrangian approaches, making it versatile for a wide range of problems, including fluid structure interactions and large deformations. It helps maintain mesh quality and accuracy over time by reducing excessive mesh distortion. The flexible mesh movement can be optimized for specific problem characteristics. However, the disadvantages are, it is more complex to implement and computationally intensive compared to purely Eulerian or Lagrangian methods. It requires sophisticated algorithms for mesh movement and remeshing to balance accuracy and computational efficiency. Let's summarize the differences between these meshing methods. Mesh movement, Eulerian. Mesh is fixed in space. Material flows through it. Lagrangian. Mesh moves with the material, follows material deformation. ALE. Mesh movement is independent and can be adjusted dynamically. Application suitability. Eulerian. Best for fluid dynamics and problems with large flows or deformations where tracking specific material points is less critical. Lagrangian. Best for solid mechanics and problems where accurate tracking of material points and interfaces is crucial. ALE. Best for complex problems involving both large deformations and fluid structure interactions, balancing the strengths of both Eulerian and Lagrangian methods. Mesh distortion. Eulerian. No mesh distortion as the mesh is fixed. Lagrangian. Prone to significant distortion with large deformations, requiring remeshing. ALE. Mesh distortion is controlled by dynamic adjustment, reducing the need for frequent remeshing. In order to explain to you more clearly and effectively the options that I have described in the slides, and to clarify the differences in the types of meshing methods that have been discussed, we will now use the Abaqus software. Here, I have prepared two models related to the forging process. These models are completely similar to each other, except for one difference. In one model, we used the ALE technique, and in the other model, we did not. First, I need to explain that to use the ALE technique, you can do so in the step module. Go to the Others tab and choose the ALE Adaptive Mesh Domain Manager and choose the step where you want the ALE method to be applied. Now, I have one step here, which shows the same step. Click on Edit and select the region where you want the ALE technique to be applied. Since I have already selected it, I will not do it again. Here, you have two control tools for ALE, remeshing sweeps per increment and frequency. These tools allow you to control the remeshing process during your simulation. The first tool specifies the number of remeshing sweeps per increment, while the second option indicates how often the remeshing process will occur after a specific number of increments. These numbers can be selected based on experience. I have entered the numbers here. Now, to more clearly see the differences between using the ALE technique and not using it, you can compare these two models simultaneously. I will select both models and display the output. In this model, where we did not use the ALE technique, the final shape of the meshes after deformation looks like this. You can see that the mesh sizes are smaller here, the meshes are stretched, and there are empty spaces. This indicates that our simulation can significantly deviate from the real state. Now, let's observe this from the beginning of the deformation process. As you can see, as the punch moves downward and the process proceeds, the material deforms. The elements in this specific area experience significant changes. In problems involving severe deformations, it is possible to encounter a mesh distortion error. On our website, we have prepared blogs that address Abaqus errors and methods for preventing and resolving these errors. You can refer to these related blogs for more information. In this part, you can clearly see the disarray of the elements. Now, I have simulated this model with the ALE technique, and the difference is clearly visible. You can compare these two techniques side by side. As you can see, when using the ALE technique, due to the simultaneous remeshing during deformation, the difference is clear. We do not observe the disarray of the meshes, making the improvement in the simulation evident. The meshes remain completely organized during deformation, and we have no additional or unnecessary changes in the meshes. This is why it is crucial to use the ALE method, if applicable, in our simulation. By doing so, we significantly reduce the probability of encountering mesh distortion errors. As mentioned in the blogs and other tutorial videos, one effective method to prevent mesh distortion errors in Abaqus models is by using the ALE technique. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you found it useful. Have a great time.